Here, I'm very happy to hear that you experienced the Holy Spirit when you were younger, and then, but the point is how to keep it. You find it not easy to keep it. Actually, the key, there are a few ways to few things we do, and it will keep it. And the most important of all is the Spirit, worship in Spirit and in truth. But I will start with the first one. First is to repent of all our sins, because sins will block the work of the Holy Spirit, because He is holy. God is holy. So any kind of lust, any kind of negative thoughts. Now, but people say, it's too hard. When people say, I see beautiful girls, it's hard not to have lust. The point is, you know, God is good, and He has a wonderful plan in your life. If you follow Him totally, God's plan will come true in your life, and your life will go higher and higher. So our life is very precious. Like for me, I go to different countries and I bless many people. My life is very precious, and your life is very precious too. I don't want to sin to ruin the plan of God. If I sin, I will ruin the plan of God. So I really don't want any kind of sin to affect me. So whenever there is any sinful thought in my mind, immediately I take care of that. That's very important. For instance, you look at a beautiful girl, and then you have some lust. When you're aware of that, immediately you say, this is destructive. Even though the girl is very beautiful, but when you have lust, it will destroy your life. But if you follow God, God will have the best wife plan for you. Then you don't have to worry. But if you try your own way, you lose the best plan of God. God will provide for you, give you the best. So you just say, I love God first, and He'll, you know, seek Him, the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you. So then we'll say, okay, lust will destroy my life, so first I'm aware. Now God gave me a 5 steps to victory. You can say it with me. First, aware. Aware. So you can say it with me. Aware.
Aware.
So I'm aware of my sinful thought. And then second, destructive. It is destructive. 3, biblical principles. Apply biblical principles. So the Bible teaches us not to have lust, but to live a holy life. And then 4, pray to have strength. Pray. Number 5, I choose to obey. So I choose not to look at a beautiful girl. I choose not to have lust. I choose to have, you know, thoughts about God so that my life is pure and clean. That way, God will be very happy. And then God will bless us. So first thing, repent of all our sins and take care of our sins. Now these 5 steps to victory actually is how God works in our life. Can you repeat this with me?
Aware.
Aware. Destructive. Biblical principles.
Pray and choose
to obey. So every time you have any kind of negative thoughts like, oh, I don't like that person is not good to me, aware. And then it's destructive. Even though how bad he is, no matter how bad he is, it's his problem. I don't have to be angry with him. Like if some of your family members or some other people yell at you, and then you say, wow, oh, I get very unhappy. But if we have done something wrong, then we're asking to forgive. But if it's not our fault, then we say, well, it's his problem. I don't have to feel bad. He talks negatively, it's his problem. That way, I'm aware, it's destructive if I'm affected by him. So biblical principle is to overcome wickedness with goodness. I would be nice to him, I don't worry about him, I don't have to be afraid of him, and I pray and I choose to be nice to him. I choose to forgive and have compassion. All people who hurt us, all people who hurt other people actually have been hurt by people many times. So they have a habit of being angry with people and yell at people. They have hatred or negative thinking. So I'm aware of that and I say, it's okay, I don't worry about it. So that's first key to have the infilling Holy Spirit, very important. Repent and turn away from our sin and hate sins. But don't hate beautiful girls, hate sins. We can talk to beautiful girls like people, not as You know, some people think of them, oh, beautiful girl, beautiful body. But think of them as human being. We respect them. We're nice to them, but we don't have lustful thoughts. So whenever we have lustful thoughts, immediately we take care of them. So first, take care of sins. Second, read the Bible. Now, some people think, I have the Holy Spirit, I don't need to read the Bible. The Bible tells all kinds of good things about God. If you hold on to these good things, then you have faith. I have faith in God because God says, you know, the Bible says, we love because God first loved us. He loves me so much, so I don't have to worry about anything. He will take care of me, He helps me, so that way it gives us strength, gives us confidence. So the Bible and faith. Faith means I really believe God will do what He promised to do. He promised to bless me, He promised to be with me, He is happy with anyone who hunger for Him, so I have faith. And every time I pray, it's like this. Oh Lord, I know You're happy with me. You come to bless me. I pray like this. But some people pray like this. Oh God, when will You come to help me? Oh, I'm in difficulties, please. Oh, I need You. Now, they think, they pray like this, God will help them. God will help them. But they actually basically pray without faith. They pray. They think that God is a cruel man. It's unfair. God is not nice. You have to ask Him, God, be nice, be nice, be nice. But actually, God is very nice. So have faith that He really loves us. Every time we pray to Him, He's very happy. And the fourth thing is a very important thing, is to worship in spirit and in truth. Now for many people, this is hard. So what does it mean to worship in spirit and truth? It's not just worship in the tongue, or the head. Some people just pray, oh God, give me more money. Oh, give me a beautiful girl. Give me this, give me that. It's just the mind and just one other thing. We want to worship. The Bible says, love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your mind, all your strength, all the whole being. The whole being with the spirit and the soul. And the soul includes three things. Can you say with me? The mind.
The mind,
the will,
the will,
and feelings.
Feeling.
What does it mean? Mind, I agree with everything in the Bible. I agree that God is good. I always have positive thinking about God. Positive thinking about my life because God has a wonderful plan. So the first thing is thinking according to the Bible. Will, my life, I really want to follow God. I really want to obey God. Do you want to obey God and serve God? You know, if you want to, God will bless you. Let me tell you, I'm almost 66. Another week, I'll be 66. And now some people, 66, they're happy to retire, go fishing every day, go play tennis every day. I just want to serve God until I cannot do it anymore. Because I see that serving God and blessing people is the best thing that will happen to me. So my life is totally for God, and God gave me strength. Now, there are people younger than me, and they cannot read small letters, but God has blessed me. I don't need eyeglasses. I can read small letters, and I have good muscles. I have good strength. God knows who loves Him, and He'll bless you, bless your whole life. So my will, I want to follow God all my life. And then feelings. You know, when I look at all the delicious food God has created, I like it. And I like God who created the beautiful food, wonderful food, and the beautiful nature, and created people have feelings. We have feelings. Mm-hmm. And that's wonderful. Even dogs have feelings. Yes. Dogs remember the master and the friends. And it's because God has feelings. And so, when I think of God, I like Him. Now, some people, when they think of God, they're afraid. They fear God. They're afraid of God. But for me, I think of God, I like Him. So when you can like God, when I pray, actually one way to think of praying is like God all the time. Lord, You're so good. I like You. I want You. I need You. If all day long you're saying, God is so good, I like You, that's already building up a connection. And then you can pray for other people, pray for yourself, pray for the church, pray for this land. But first, like God. And then the whole spirit ascend to God. Now, when I pray, it's think of the whole spirit fly to God like a bird. Oh, Jesus, I love you. I want you. Now, this is something it takes time to learn. But you really like God, you really want God, you want to follow God, and your whole spirit come to God. And you will notice, I will pray for you in a moment, you notice that you instantly experience something. That is from the spirit. So this is the fourth key. Very important. Worship in spirit and truth. And then hunger for Him. Really, I want it. And then obeying Him in every way. And preach the gospel. And build up spiritual life. The great commandment. Number six. Number seven, take care of problems in life. Any kind of negative emotions, negative thinking, like your family member is not nice to you, or sometimes we think, I'm not an important person, I'm no good, nobody likes me. That will you have to be taken care of. Where they say, God likes me. When no one likes me, doesn't matter. If I care about them, virtually they will like me. So we can overcome any kind of negative thinking, any kind of negative emotion, a negative subconscious mind. What is subconscious mind? Let me ask you, in your dreams, do you have good dreams? Do you have good dreams or dream that you are afraid?
Afraid.
Huh?
No, not afraid.
That's good. Now, the subconscious mind will come up in the dreams. When you are unhappy, it will show in the dreams. When you are unhappy, it will come up easily. So that's a subconscious mind that you are not aware of. Because in the past, people have hurt you. It hides inside you. So we need to heal that too. So every day you say, when you wake up, you say, Lord, the Lord loves me. God is with me. God blesses me. Hallelujah. Every day you start like that. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I want to follow you. I'll bless people, and God will like me. God likes me, and God will bless me. That way, you have positive thinking all day long. And then in these few days, I'm going to tell you how to use that for ministry. So these are a few keys to be filled with the Holy Spirit. So I hope you do this every day. And then every day you do it, you find that you go back to when you were young, how you experienced the Holy Spirit easily. So first, repenting of all sins and turn away from the sins. Hating sin is the key to overcoming sins. Hating sins because sins are destructive. Second, the Bible. Read the Bible and believe the Bible. Believe the promises of God. And then faith. God is good. God likes me. When I fail, then I say, Lord, please forgive me. And then God is very happy. And then I follow God. God is very happy. So every time, remember, if we've done something bad, we'll say, Lord Jesus, I'm really sorry. And please forgive me. And God is happy in heaven. Worship in spirit and truth. Whole spirit. The mind, the will, the feelings, and the whole spirit. And then really hunger for God and obey God and the Great Commission. And then take care of problems in life. And then you will go higher and higher. But you need to be trained also. In these few days, I'm going to do training for you. How to pray for people, how to preach the Word of God, how to serve God. And then you'll have power of God. And then I want to come back here again. So in the future, if someone can arrange some meetings for me, your church is open, you can tell your pastor about it, I can come back to bless your church for free. They don't have to pay me. I'll come back to bless them. So now we're going to practice. Now you stand up now. And open your heart to God and really like God. Really hunger for God. And see if you can experience something. And then I will lay hand on you. And you might immediately experience His presence. So in your heart you say, Lord, you're so wonderful. I want you. I need you. I want you. God, you're so good. So we really like Him. God, you're so good. I like you. I worship you.
potentially down or like this, down.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you feel the swaying power? Do you feel stronger than yesterday when you pray at home yourself? So the Holy Spirit is staying in you, stronger. It's stronger in you now. Open your heart more. Hunger for God. You say, God, you're so good. I like you. From the bottom of your heart. Now you can cry out to God like this. Hallelujah. I love you, Jesus. I want you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Now you can say this. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now, do you feel a stronger presence now?
Yeah.
Wonderful. Yeah. Now, so keep doing this. Now I'm going to pray for you. Relax. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Loves me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, fill it with the Holy Spirit. Fill it with the anointing of God. Fill it with the love of God and the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And the peace of God, the love of God, fill him all the way. Oh, Lord Jesus, touch him. Touch him so he can sense your love. So you can sense your love, your presence. Lord Jesus, you're so good. You're so good. You're so wonderful. You're so wonderful. Oh, God is good. You have experienced the Holy Spirit too. For a high level. You already carry the anointing of God. You already have the anointing of God upon you right now. Do you like to share? Do you like to share in front of the camera? Is that okay?
No.
No. Okay. But can you just share? Can you just say here? Say loudly. Close your eyes and describe what you experienced.
I felt more peaceful.
Uh-huh. More peaceful.
And I felt that I don't have to worry.
You don't have to worry.
I don't have to worry.
Mm-hmm.
You have a great plan for me. I don't have to worry. Really.
Hallelujah. Do you feel?
I feel like, I don't know, something heavy here.
Yeah, something heavy on your hand. It came from the presence of God. And you feel the whole body light, right?
Yeah.
Floating.